Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and today I'm here with a tag again. It's a lot of tags, I know, but I saw that Anya and Cher, I want to say Cher, but I think it's Cher, made the get to know me tag, and I have a lot of new followers or subscribers, so maybe you want to know me a little bit better. And I don't know if I have done a tag like this when my channel has been in English. So this was created for a blog in the beginning, but Anya made it more YouTube friendly, and it is from Sheila at Make Up Your Mind. I will leave all the info I have down in the description, and I will also leave Anya and Cher so you can watch them out. I recommend to do that. And this is a pretty long tag, so maybe this will take a little while. So this is 31 questions, and I think we just get started. So question number one, is your hair naturally curly or straight? And I have like the straightest hair in history, I think. I hate my hair, it's so fucking straight, it's like, I can't do anything about it. I can curl it, a couple hours later it's this straight again. I hate my hair, have always done. I hate straight hair, but this is my unbuildable hair. I can't do anything with it because it's just slippery and straight. Question number two, do you dye it yourself or go to a salon? And I do not dye my hair. I have dyed my hair one or two times, and I have always done it either by myself or my friends have helped me. You know, when you was like 14, 15 and you and your friends did stupid thing like dyed my hair black. So yeah, and I have had half my hair black and half my hair blonde. So I have dyed it a couple of times and always at home. Question number three, do you wear the same style every day or do you change it? And if it is regarding my hair, I have no style in my hair. It's just is. This is like the most fun thing I do, put it up in a little bun because it is in my face all the time if I don't. And yeah, so I would say it's the same every damn day. It's boring. Or I have it up in a ponytail. That's my two things. Either like that or all my hair in a ponytail. Question number four, do you do your own mani-pedi or do you go to a saloon? And I do it by myself. Right now I have nothing on my nails, but I have always done it myself. I have never went to a saloon to fix either my hands or my feet, because I like to do it myself. I have always done it. Question number five, how often do you change your nail polish? And right now I have no nail polish. I usually change it once a week, or I did before. Now I am a little bit lazy. But usually if I have nail polish, it lasts around a week. So I change it once a week. Now I haven't had one for like 2 weeks, but I have vacation and I have other things to do than fix my nails. Or else I usually fix them on Sundays so they are fresh when I go back to work at Monday. Question number six, do you polish your toes in the winter or just the summer? And before I always painted my toenails. Now I haven't done it for a long time, but if I do it, I do it all the time because why not? It's not that often that I go without shoes and socks outside my apartment. So right now I don't, but if I do, I don't care if it's winter or summer or spring or fall or whatever. Question number seven, how long does it take for you to put on makeup? And that is a hard one to answer. If I'm just sitting home alone doing my makeup because we're going out to eat, or I just want to put on my makeup, it maybe take 20 minutes. It can take up to an hour. It can take 1.5 hours if I'm like looking at YouTube videos, just taking my time, test something new. But I would say around 20 minutes to 1 hour. It is depending on what I do. And sometimes it just takes like 5 minutes if I'm just doing a light base with a mineral foundation and just eyebrows. And then it can take like, yeah, 5 minutes. So it's so hard to answer because it really depends on what I do. But between 20 minutes and 1 hour. Question number 8. What do you do first, face or eyes? And I always do my eyes first. And some people, they don't understand how you can do your eyes first. But I don't understand how you can do your face. I want to slap on as much makeup as I can and like really build it up and don't care about fallout at all. So I always do my eyes first. The times when I have done my face first, I had always screwed it up. Like get too much fallout and then try to take it away and I have like green all over my face. So I always do my eyes first because I know how frustrated I'm going to be if I get fallouts and I can't take them away. So I always do my eyes first and then my face. Question number 9, and this is a hard one. Do you collect makeup or just buy what you need when you need it? And I collect makeup, but I don't buy things just to collect them. But I buy more than I need because I don't need one more eyeshadow palette with orange color, but I still want it, but I don't need it. But I don't feel like I need to collect like certain items. Like I need all the Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. I don't feel that need to collect, but I buy more than I need. But what you need and what you want can sometimes be the same thing. So yeah, I'm not a collector in that I buy things just to collect them. But I buy more than I need. But when it comes to base products like concealer, powder and foundation, I buy what I need. Right now I think I have 2 foundations. I have this that is a liquid foundation and I have a powder foundation. And that's all the foundation I have. And I don't feel the need to buy any more foundations. Question number 10. How often do you wear false eyelashes? And almost never. I use it sometimes, but I like to wear them. But it's always like one eyelash I am so good to put on. And then I'm going to put on the next and like it gets stuck in my lashes or something. And then I just hate it. And I also hate the glue because it's really stick to my lashes. So I like never wear falses anymore. It was, I don't know, maybe 2 years ago. I used them pretty often, but not anymore because I don't have time for that. And I like the look of it, but I don't like the look of it at me, I hope. But I have a pretty much of eyelashes, but I like never use them. Question number 11. Do you do a full face of makeup every day? No. Usually, if I'm not going to record any YouTube videos, I do eyebrows and nothing more. So, no. I have not the time or energy to do a full face every day. Question number 12. Do you wear makeup when you're home, alone, or with family? And it depends what I'm doing. Sometimes I just sit down and play with makeup. Sometimes I like not wearing makeup for a whole week. It depends on so much what I'm feeling and what I'm doing. But usually when I'm like at my mom, I don't do makeup because I'm spending time with my mom. Yeah. And I'm usually there for a longer period in summer and it's warm. So, yes, if I'm going out to eat with my family, I do my makeup, but if I'm just sitting home, I do not. So, sometimes if I want to play, and usually when I'm home alone, I usually film a video and then I wear makeup, but it's nothing necessary for me, I do it if I want to. Question number 13, will you leave the house without makeup? And I do that like always. I couldn't care less. Sometimes I think about the people that work near the grocery store near here, there I'm going. pretty often. They have seen me in full glam. They have seen me when I just woken up. They have seen me when I had a fever for a week. They have seen me like all the stages. And yeah, I think about that sometimes. I don't know why. But no, I don't have to have any makeup on when I go out. Question number 14. How many high-end products do you have? And I don't know. I have more drugstore than high-end. I think I have most indie, then drugstore, and then high-end. Because I am not into like super high-end brands. Nothing like foundation or powder or anything. And when it comes to eyeshadows, I like indie brands more. And when it comes to lipstick, I like indie brands more. So I don't have... I think that is the smallest category in my makeup collection is high-end. Question number 15. Do you plan your outfit of the day every night or decide when you're getting dressed? And okay, when I'm at work, I need to have a special shirt. I need to have like working clothes or a working... what is it even called? It's not a sweater. It's like a long sleeve t-shirt or a t-shirt. I need to have it when I'm at work. And then I just have black jeans. And yeah. And sometimes I do plan my outfit of the day the night before. But I always change it because when I put it on the next day, I'm like looking at myself in the mirror and I guess, no, I am not going to wear this. So I try, but it usually ends up with me taking something else. Question number 16. How often do you change your handbag? And I think I do it pretty often. I have a lot of handbags. Not any expensive handbags because I don't have leather handbags. But I change them depending on how much things I need to bring with me. And what I am doing and which clothes I have. So I change it pretty often. I don't have like a handbag that is my favorite. I change them depending on how many things I'm getting with me and what I'm wearing. Question number 17. 17. What time do you wake up and go to sleep? And I'm going to sound so old. I usually wake up by myself at 7 o'clock if I have not put on an alarm. And I am not a morning person, but I'm trying to... I think I'm starting to be a morning person. But if I'm going to work, I get up at 5:45. And I try to go to sleep at 10 p.m. Because if I go later, I'm going to be so tired. So, yeah. And if it's weekend, I maybe stay up to 12 or 1 p.m. A.m. A.m. it must be. In Sweden, you often talk like this 24-hour watch, not a.m. and p.m. And then I go up around 9 maybe, if I don't have anything important to do. So I usually wake up at 7 and then I go back to sleep and sleep maybe until 8 or 9. So yeah, it depends on what I'm doing and if I'm free or if I'm going to work. Question number 18. How often or when do you work out? And right now, nothing. It was a period in my life when I worked out like 5 days a week. It was long ago. But I try when I'm working. Now I have not been home for a while and we have done other things. But I usually try to take walks maybe 3 times a week. Just because it makes me sleep better, I feel better, and I can listen to podcasts. And I love to listen to podcasts about murder, of course. So I try to take walks maybe 3 or 4 times a week. It depends. Sometimes I'm getting in like this walking spree and I am out walking 5 or 6 days a week. Right now, nothing, but I hope I will get back on track with my walking habits after my vacation is over, so I can sleep better at night. Question number 19. Left-handed or right-handed? And I am right-handed, but I do some things like a left-handed person. I eat the wrong way. I hold my fork in my right hand because I'm going to stare with this. I'm just going to cut with a knife. I can't understand why people do the other way around. It's hard for me. And I also think I can do some things with my left hand that right-handed people normally can't. I have pretty much control with my left hand. This sounds so strange. But when I was little, my mom thought that I was going to be left-handed because I did everything with my left hand. But I am right-handed. Question number 20. How tall are you? And I have to write down here how much it is in feet. I am 164.5 centimeters. So I think I am not super short, but I think I am in the shorter category of people. And I always feel that I'm longer than I are. I don't know why. But I am 164.5 centimeters tall or short. It depends how you look at it. Question number 21. Do you speak any foreign languages? Yes, I speak English, as you can hear. I am from Sweden, for you that don't know. And I speak English. Almost every Swede in my age and a little bit higher, we speak English because we learn it in school. So yeah. And then also, fun fact about Swedes. We can understand like Norwegian and Danish, and they can understand us, some of the words at least, because it's pretty similar, but it's not the same language, but it's pretty similar. But I don't speak Norwegian or Danish, but I can understand. Question number 22. How many pets do you have? And I have two. I have two cats. I love my cats with my whole heart. And as soon as we buy a house, we're going to buy a cat. I have wanted one more cat. Actually, I want two more cats because I want them to be able to be two and two, but yeah. Question number 23. How often are you on YouTube? And I don't want to answer this because I'm on YouTube all the time. I watch so much YouTube videos. I have so many friends on YouTube and I just love YouTube. I am at YouTube like a couple of hours every day. Now, the last 3 weeks I haven't been because I have been away. I keep nagging on my vacation, and when you see this I am back at work, but usually maybe 4 hours a day. And remember that I have a full-time job, so four hours a day is pretty much then. Okay, question number 24. Do you read comments posted on videos? And yes, I do. I like to see what others comment, so usually when I watch a video I scroll down to the comments and see if anybody has something fun to say. So yes, I read comments on YouTube videos. Question number 25. Do you keep a list of products to try as you see other videos? No. I have a little list now when I'm on my low buy of things that I want to buy. Maybe not necessarily like things I'm going to buy, but things that I maybe want to buy. But nothing more than that. Nothing like a list that I update regularly. Or something like that. Maybe if somebody's testing out single shadows, I can write them down. Because it's sometimes hard to keep track on maybe single shadows, but nothing like, not like a good list with things. Question number 26. How did you came up with your channel name? And my channel name, I think that some people think that Lisa Lobotomy is my real name. It is not. My first name is Lisa, but my last name is not Lobotomy. And I did a collab with Jessica, Stars Hollywood Jessica, where we talked about this. But if you haven't seen that video, it's on her channel, not on mine. I can take it once again. I wanted something that sounded pretty cool. Not cool, but I wanted something not like my normal name, because my last name is not fun. It's a typical Swedish name, and one of my last name has an Ö in it, which isn't existing in the rest of the world. So I was like thinking, okay, it is in emo and scenecore, you can have a stage name, And then it should be your first name, and then the last name should start with the same letter. And it should be something a little bit more gory. So I was like, Lisa Lobotomy. There's no Lisa Lobotomy on YouTube or Instagram. So yeah, that's how I came up with my name. And also, I like lobotomy. I think it's an interesting thing to do. 27. What kind of camera do you use for your photographs and videos? For my Instagram, my personal Instagram, and also sometimes my YouTube Instagram, I use my phone. This is a Samsung Galaxy S7. And my camera that I'm filming with is a Canon EOS 600D. I think it's T3 Rebel, or something in US. I want to buy a new one because I want autofocus on it, but it is okay. It's enough, but I want a new camera. Question number 28. How often do you clean your house? And we try to clean once a week. Now it has not been that way, but we try to do like the whole apartment, like the entire bathroom and everything once a week. And then of course some days when it's messy in the kitchen, we clean that, but like the whole apartment with like vacuuming and stuff like that, once a week we try at least. I hate to clean, it's so freaking boring. Question number 29. What is your favorite color? When it comes to clothes and other stuff, it's black. And when it comes to makeup, it is orange, or red or yellow. I think orange. Question number 30. Do you swear? And I think I did it in the beginning of this video, and yes, I do. I try to not do it, and I don't do it too often. I do it when I get angry or if I want to, like, I can't remember that word on English. If I'm like mad or if I'm super happy, to reinforce, and then I swear sometimes, but I try to not swear. And I think there is good swear words and bad swear words. And question 31. What are you going to do with the rest of your day? And it's actually soon 6 p.m. and I am going to stop recording this. I'm going to wash off this makeup, then I'm going to take a shower, a quick shower, and then me and my boyfriend are going out for dinner. I maybe should go like this. It would save some time. Maybe I just shower my body, but that's what I'm going to do. And I'm also going to edit the video and try to have it up for tomorrow morning because it's Sunday today. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. Going out to eat at one of my favorite restaurants. And maybe buy some candy after that. Eat some candy and watch something. So yeah, that's the rest of my day, and this was all for this tag. It was pretty long, I think, and I'm going to tag some people down below, and if I'm not tagging you and you want to do it, just do it and tell me, because it's so fun to know a little bit more about people. And I really hope you like this video, and I will of course leave Anya and Cher down in the description, and I think they also will be up here. So I really hope you like this video, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!